Australia. Big round of applause for my very loyal, good friends and judges. Okay, you guys know the rules. Candid, to the point, just give honest feedback to these great entrepreneurs. And for those who've been coming for many years, they're getting better and better every year. So you've got to not be shocked at how amazing these are. You've got to still ask hard questions. So I need you guys to ask the hard, candid questions, even though they're getting better and better. So let's please welcome our first company. So meet Bill and Lynn. They recently just moved here from Los Angeles. They moved from a big house into a small house. They've got a housewarming party coming up in a week, and they need to get a sofa quick. Bill, he's a football Sunday kind of guy, and Lynn, on the other hand, she's not. She wants to buy a piece of furniture. She wants to sit on it. You know, Bill just wants to buy online, that sort of thing. Definitely does not want to waste his weekend shopping for furniture. So Bill finds BenchmadeModern.com online, but they head on down to the San Francisco store. Now, when they walk into the store, they notice it's a small store. It's a hybrid store. It's about 800 square feet. Ice cream shop size. There's 8 sofas on the back wall. There's 2 kiosks pulsing. There's a yellow robot, Petunia, kind of gestures them in. When they walk into the kiosk, they hit the browse button, and immediately those 8 sofas appear on the screen. Now they've already kind of shopped for Tyler online. They know that Tyler is the sofa for them. And they click on that, and then they're asked, would you like to see the sofa? Well, yeah, that's why we came. So they click yes, and the robot grabs it off the wall, brings it down, puts it very carefully on the floor in front of them, and allows Lynn to kind of touch and feel and sit on it and make sure that it's a comfortable sofa. Now, they could go back and get another sofa and back and forth, but they know that this sofa is what they want. So, they choose that sofa, they swipe through to the sofa that's closest to what they need, they choose it, they want to read a little bit more about it, they choose brown, that's the color that they want, they click on that, and at this point, they can customize the size. Now, these sofas come anywhere from 10 feet by the inch, all the way down to 35 inches. They slide their finger all the way down to 63. And they could print the sofa out. They could hit the print button. And they could actually take this print to their home. They could lay it out on the floor and put it up against the wall and make sure that it's a perfect fit. Now, there's 3-inch increments going one way to the other, so they can make it bigger or smaller. They can, you know, fit it in between to their existing side tables and make sure it's perfect. They can place a swatch there and kind of visualize it and make sure that it's exactly what they need. But in this case, they don't have time for that. Bill's already measured it once, twice. He's done all his homework, and he knows that he wants a 63-inch sofa. So, they want to buy it. So they swipe at the kiosk, they go to purchase it. They are given the option now to how quickly do they want to have that sofa delivered. Now, within 7 days, Benchmade will make that sofa custom for them. But in this case, they've got a party coming up in under a week, and they need to get that sofa made in a hurry, so they expedite it, and they have it made within 24 hours. That's a custom sofa in one of 50 colors, made to order and made in 24 hours. Now they know the Benchmade factory is in Los Angeles, so let's say that's what, like, you know, 12 hours, say, to get here. So in 36 hours, the sofa arrives, 2 guys carry it up into their house, places it, allows Lynn to sit on it, and she immediately notices quality of the sofa is about the same as the design of the Reach sofa, but it was $1,000 less. It's very similar in price to a Crate & Barrel sofa, except for this one is custom and they didn't have to wait 6, 8, 12 weeks. They have a great party. They can't stop talking about the robots, the whole experience. Did the first furniture buying experience, and it's been great for them. Anyway, thank you very much. We are Benchmade Modern. We're making sofas in as little as 24 hours. We're going beta today with 4 collections. Two of those collections can be expedited within 24 hours. The store is opening up in San Francisco within 6 months, and the robot is being made today. Thank you. Okay, questions from our judges?
I'll kick it off. Awesome. Very cool. I love the robot. Talk to me a little bit about the incumbents. You talked about Design Within Reach and Crate & Barrel. How are the economics different of the business, and how do you try and totally change these guys and the model you guys are building?
So both Crate & Barrel and Design Within Reach, they all buy from a factory, right? So there's a markup there. We actually already own the factory. It's in Los Angeles. We're already building sofas today. So the cost model that, say, Design Within Reach, that adds a significant amount of money just in their stores and their locations. Our whole model is built off the fact that these hybrid stores. There's never been a furniture store in an 800 square foot little location. So we're allowing that online experience, yet allowing someone to actually sit on it in the store, and we can chop a ton of overhead right off the top.
What are the margins on this? What are the margins?
So it costs us about six, for a sofa of this size, about $600 to make. We sell it for about $1,700. So there's a big gap there. Now, in that price, we include delivery, okay? So in San Francisco, we can deliver that sofa for about $125. That's white glove. Now, we ship all over the country. The price, of course, changes to New York. You know, we do really well in our San Francisco store. We lose a little bit going to New York City. But there's enough margin there to, you know, take care of the printout and that sort of thing.
I like the idea of having a robot in the store, but it's gimmicky, right? It's sort of fancy. What I want, and I think this is in mind what Jason was saying, I actually want to be able to hit a print button and have the sofa in an hour actually fabricated behind the scenes in the store. How far away are we, and are you going in that direction?
Well, I would imagine that we're pretty far away. I don't know that they're printing comfort just as of yet. You know, we are making a real sofa in 24 hours. That's damn near printed. I mean, we're using a little bit of technology tricks, you know, right at the purchase. You know, everything is kind of going off in various directions. And remember, this is custom. This is a custom sofa. So that's typically like 14 weeks and, you know, $4,000.
Talk to me about the capacity of these frames. So I imagine that in the store, there's only one robot, right? So if there's a couple of families ahead of you, you might be waiting a long time to get access to the robot.
Yeah.
And also on the manufacturing side, how many can you make in the factory you have right now?
Yeah, so in the factory that we have right now, we're currently producing about 10 sofas a day, you know, anywhere from 30 to, you know, 40 a month, depending on the week. The interesting thing about the sofa business is we can add lines, right? It's a line of 7 people. So on one line, we're doing that. It's very scalable. We're in Los Angeles for a very particular reason. That's the sofa capital, know, of this side of the country. So there's lots of labor. So it's a relatively easy thing to continue to add these very systematic lines to be able to produce as we scale.
Okay, final question, Clark. Which problem do you start off trying to solve? You know, the user experience problem, the retail problem, the costing problem?
Honestly, like, how many people here have bought a piece of furniture and it's basically sucked? The whole experience is awful. You've waited way too long. You know, this is something that we deal with. So I wanted to solve that problem first of how do we make this a good buying experience. The gimmicky side of the robot, right? It actually, like, you can't lift a sofa. We're using that wall space to stack the sofas. That's why we can get so small. The robot isn't that expensive. It pays for itself very quickly if we had employees lifting it back and forth. So we're trying to create a fun and exciting experience on a simple product, and we're using a little bit of technology along the way to speed the process up. Let's hear it for Benchmade. Well done.